Neighborhood, a documentary series about Bostonians and the places they call home. Next on Neighborhoods, meet Tom Menino, a behind-the-scenes look at grassroots Boston politics. A Hyde Park native son tries to turn a lifetime of friendships into a seat on the city council. On Neighborhoods.
The following program is a co-production of WGBH Boston and Cablevision of Boston.
Morning. Hi. Hi. Morning. How you doing? I'm Tom Menino. Hi, nice to see you. How you doing?
Great day in our lives.
So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate your party with you. Come on now.
Hey, this thing ain't gonna hold more than.
Let's all celebrate and have a good time.
It's my privilege to introduce the next city councilman, Tom Menino.
I am today announcing my candidacy for the office of district council
for the city of Boston. I have chosen
to announce my candidacy for my father's home. First, because my father, like my wife Angela, my children Tom and Susan, has been a very special person in my life. More than anyone else, he has given me the encouragement to seek this office.
Vote down.
It has been a city council that played one neighborhood against another while looking for support from each when it came to election time.
Let me say something about the new office of district councilor. First, it is not an office for on-the-job training. It will demand someone who understands those issues, like physical policy.
Fiscal. It's coming out physical.
Like physical policy and planning that affect the entire city. I believe that I am that kind of person who can meet these demands. I know that with your help,
we can accomplish these tasks. I know that with your help, we can accomplish the tasks that face us.
I ask that you join me to make this neighborhood, our neighborhood, safe and secure once more.
Then the crowd scream and holler.
Thank you very much.
Did you get your sidewalk fixed yet?
No.
It's going to get fixed. Where's that guy?
Huh?
We're going to get that sidewalk fixed, I tell you. Hey, thank you for coming. Huh? How are you? Thank you very much.
One note for you people. The headquarters is open and the address is 1400 Hyde Park Avenue. It's above Mario's Pizza and Restaurant. Thank you.
See you. Thank you very much.
Come on, let's go, guys.
Hey, Joe, how are you? Thank you very much. I talked to Larry tonight.
How are you?
Thank you.
Of course, there's no surprise that the biggest issue that bothering the people here in this district is crime. So I think when you go talk to the people, you ought to have a clear position on crime and how it affects the community and what you want to do. The next issue that shows up is taxes. Not 18% of the people mention taxes. And right behind taxes comes education. So there is some constituency out there for public education. Age group 36 to 45, they mention education 27.5% of the time. That's a big issue among that age group.
Of course, yeah.
36 to 45, they got kids in school. So.
What about the senior citizens? Get to the senior citizens.
Well, now, we have a special breakdown of senior citizens, that is.
But you know what we did? We blew it on our announcement, because in our announcement, we didn't mention senior citizens at all.
Well, senior citizens make up approximately 25% of this district. Obviously, you have to look. Three. Gotta get this. Police and fire. Their interest in police and fire issues.
Yeah, police and fire, same as crime.
Yeah, yeah. Among the elderly, 62.4%.
Because they're afraid of work. Crime.
Really afraid. Another thing I just want to point out to you is this district is made up overwhelmingly of homeowners. Not one person among the home renters mentioned rent control as an issue.
Thank God. What's the ethnic background?
Well, it's a district of about 62,000-63,000 people that is made up probably about 50% Irish and 20% Italian, and various, perhaps 8% blacks, and the other ethnic groups, small percentages of English and Polish, Jewish. It's slightly more conservative, I would say, than other districts. Economically, it's a fairly well-off community. At least one-third of the people here, families here, are in income bracket over 20,000. I'm not saying that people make over 20,000. I'm saying it's family units. The combined income is 20,000. I'd say the average out here is somewhere about 10 to 15,000. 34% of the households are union. So one-third union and two-thirds not union. Heavily working class.
Well, it was the railroads and the river power that was the energy for the mills of Hyde Park. They had the Mother Brook, which was the first canal, commercial canal, providing all the water power. So it was an ideal location. And from the beginnings in 1850 or so, it was primarily industrial. In 1868, it might be possible to say that it was almost wholly a Yankee town. But very shortly, in about 20 years, or 1888, 1890, there was a great number of immigrants coming in. They came in to follow the industries, the mills. The first wave of immigrants was Irish. Then very, very closely, though, in the late 1880s and 90s, the Italian immigrations came.
Well, we called it the Avenue, yeah? And it was nice here. We had old people like my father and mother, real Italians, didn't speak the English language at all. My father, maybe a little bit. My mother, none. None at all. My father came to this country a long time ago, you know. A long time ago. He was born in 1871. One of the first ones to come to this country. From Italy, that is. He worked with a shovel and a pick. He worked every day, too. Wind, rain, or snow, it didn't make any difference. He worked. Most of them worked that same way, in pick and shovel, or they worked in these industrial factories, like Mercantile was down here. Westinghouse was up here.
I think my father worked there for 30-some-odd years,
in Weston House. I think we were brought up in Weston House. I think my two aunts worked there. My three aunts worked there. My father worked there all his life. I worked there for a few summers. You know, it's been a real important part of our family. It's Weston House. No, in Hyde Park, Weston House was the main employer out here. Everybody worked in Weston House. That was the place to work. Oh, in the heyday, they made industrial fans, the large fans that go into tunnels and things like that. And today it's a little different. A little different. It's on a decline now, and they have some financial problems.
I reside in this pink house in the corner, the only pink house in Reval that I bought 5 years ago at a reasonable price, and it's the first house I ever owned. Reval, some people say, is God's country because it's the furthest part away from the core of the city, because we don't usually have the problems that the inner city has. Since the campaign started, I haven't fixed anything in this house. Oh, when I got involved in politics was when I was 13 years old. My dad had a friend of his who was a state representative from Hyde Park, and he gave me some cards to hand out for his friend, and that's when I got bitten by the bug, and I've been involved, I think, ever since.
Well, after high school, that's where we had our trouble. He didn't want to go to school no more after high school. In fact, I had him going to BC at night, but he didn't last very long there. He used to say, when I get after him to go to college, he'd say, Truman never went to college. That's exactly right.
Doris, Tommy, how are you?
And he told me that 1,000 times. Because I wanted Tommy to get into better things, actually. I don't know what, but he was interested in politics and us all.
This picture here is when I was the chief marshal of the Hyde Park Mattapan Scholarship Banquet Committee. We raised money for a period of 10 years for students from Hyde Park High to send them to college. And this picture up here is it's Senator Joseph F. Timilty, who has been a long friend and associate for many, many years with my dad. Joe Timilty ran for mayor of Boston 3 times, was never successful, ran against Kevin White. And presently, he's a state senator from Hyde Park, Canton, Sharon, and Stoughton. There's several pictures here of my involvement with President Jimmy Carter. Probably the greatest thrill I ever had was flying on Air Force One. I mean, every American should fly on it. This picture right here is the first trip of the 1980 presidential campaign by Vice President Mondale into the Northeastern Pennsylvania. I was the Northeast Pennsylvania coordinator in 1980. I think the whole thing represents the things I've done in public, for the most part.
What are they doing now? Mr. Menino's running for city council.
We've had problems with the water coming out of the George Wright Golf Course. Mr. Menino's been able to get us in touch with who can get the problem fixed. He's also double-checked on the people we've talked to make sure that they are getting the job done.
We've known Senator Timilty and Tommy Menino for quite a while. In fact, I was involved with some lobbying activities up at the State House with Tom Menino, trying to promote safe driving. Because as of right now, all a person has to do is take a 45-hour course to become a driving instructor, and we feel that that's totally ludicrous.
Particularly, I had a personal problem with my mother-in-law. He was very, very helpful in getting during that time of need that I needed him.
My name is Joe Lasorda. I was raised in Hyde Park. I played ball in Hyde Park, sandlot ball. We built homes in Hyde Park. And Tom Menino is dedicated.
Hi, I'm Tom Menino.
Public servant.
How are you? I'm running for district city councilor. Hi, I'm Tom Menino.
It's a different experience for me to be a candidate than being the guy who always was behind the scenes to talk about myself and talk about the things I feel, because usually I never talked about the things I felt. I always talked about the other guy's feelings. And I just think it'd be a different experience altogether, complete different experience.
Will you back?
Oh! Hi, I'm Tom Menino. I'm running for district city councilor. Appreciate a vote in September.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right.
Being a smiler and a shaker of hands and the things like that. The things that are not natural. Well, that's the part of the campaign that I had the most problem with.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you
very much.
You're welcome. Bye.
Good luck with the
book. Nervous. Great anxiety. These are the toughest things in the world to have because you don't know. We've sold. We have $4,500 in hand right now, but you don't know who's going to show up. All we need is people now. Thanks for coming. Really appreciate you coming. Seriously, thanks a lot. You know, people don't know how much money you have in hand. They only see what kind of crowd you could draw. And that could change a lot of things in the campaign. That's why I'm worried about who's going to show and who's not going to show.
Hey, Joe, how are you?
Thank you for coming. Thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Stephen.
Stephen, how are you? I see you. Thank you for coming.
Co-workers.
Oh, good. You're living down 242 White Park Avenue?
Yeah.
Excellent, excellent. I know that address.
They're not only union people here, although union people, but more or less they're getting back at this fundraiser, and we owe a great deal of Tom Menino.
The Western House local endorsed us last week. First time they ever endorsed a candidate. And this place, 103, the waitresses union endorsed me, the bartenders. Yeah, they got a waitress to get you some drinks. Sure.
Hello, everybody look up. For those of you who don't know, which is about 99% of the people here, my name is Ron McDougall, and I'm from Local 2222, the Telemo workers, who are very strong supporters of Tom Menino. I'd like to introduce some people here from Labor. First, I have the Labor Man of the Year, Joe Joyce from the Sheet Metal Workers, who was supported Tom strongly. From the steel workers, we have somewhere out there Ed Dixon and Jack Friel, if they want to stand up. Now to the business at hand. Here he is, our candidate, Tom Menino.
What time's the meeting?
7:30. Supposedly it's a cookout for the workers.
I should go up there and shake hands, huh?
Supposedly it's private.
Here, over here. Son. One here. And push that down like that, all right? Another Coke, right? 16 Cokes.
Yay!
Aw, I know. But it's easier that way.
Yeah, it's much.
All right, now everybody take a piece first, all right?
Ow!
Don't be bashful. Why don't we do it for you?
Yeah. Ow.
Right, I'll do it. I'll do it.
I think I have.
I'm Tom Menino then.
Very good. Hi. To meet you.
How are you? That's right. It's the Hyde Park District. Hi, how are you? What are you playing?
King of the Corner. King of the Corner. You're going to be King of the Corner.
Appreciate you. Think about me when the election is. Thank you.
She's out.
Bye now.
Don't forget, girl.
She's out.
Hey, nice seeing you. Thank you. Bye now. I need your help. Revitalization of Rosendale Square, which is probably, you know, my top priority and probably one of the things I talk about most in the campaign. And I think that's one of the main thrusts that I will be dealing with when I get elected, is revitalization of Rosendale Square, because, as I said before, as Rosendale Square goes, the rest of the neighborhood goes.
It seems like anything the city's tried to do down in Rosendale Square to dress it up, someone's come along and torn the trees down or dug up the cobblestones and...
The area down there doesn't warrant. People won't go into that area because of the crime down there. You know, people are afraid, women are afraid to go shopping because their handbags are going to be stolen all the time.
Yeah, Roach Brothers down there, before they're up on West Rockbury, they got burnt out.
Oh, yeah, but...
A lot of them have been burnt out.
Some of those...
Calibers that are fired.
That's all gone.
We have to bring it back. You know, you only... In Rosendale Square today, you have 13 pizza places, which is crazy.
Is there any restaurants and coffee shops and sub shops that they have to be...
people using them in order for those people to be making money. So they're coming into Rosendale Square to buy their coffee. Why can't we get them to buy something else down there?
Don't have a quality store. Probably the last quality store down there was Fox.
I'd like to welcome everyone tonight to the first of a few candidate nights that the Washington Hill Community Association and Rosendale Civic Association will be putting on over the next couple of months. And I will be your moderator tonight. I'm the director of Washington Hill, Bob Mazzetti, which I know no one knows me. The first candidate to speak is Richard Kenny.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think for the first time in more than a generation, we have the opportunity to get the representation in District 5 that we so badly need. I think as a result of the benign neglect over the years, that District 5, as a result of this benign neglect, has been without proper police protection, proper public services in general.
I want to join together with you, the people of Rosendale, to ensure that our diverse neighborhoods have a voice in the city's administration.
Because you see, the city has been under attack for about 30 years. And the same people out to destroy this nation are destroying the city.
I've been running my campaign on a law and order basis, and I have now fallen into line and say that law and order is something we should have, which we all know. Tommy Menino put out a pamphlet stating that we should reestablish team police. Tom has asked for a special prosecutor for habitual criminals and major violators. We've had this for years. Tom's been taking credit for a lot of things, so he must take blame. 86.5% of the people of this district, 86.5% of the people of this district voted for capital punishment. But Timothy and Scott, you're two peas in the pod, say that no, we don't care what the people want. We're advisor. My advisor here said, oh no, we don't want capital punishment. From July until the end of August, in the city of Boston alone, we've had one murder a day, and sometimes two. Now, if we don't get capital punishment back here and enforce it, you won't be able to walk out in the street. You know that, and I know.
The next candidate we'll hear from is Thomas Menino.
First, I want to thank the Washington Hill Civic Association and the Rosendale Civic Association for allowing us to have this forum tonight. It's the first forum of the campaign where we can discuss the issues of this campaign. I'd also like to thank Bill Broderick for giving me his 3 minutes, so I have 6 minutes tonight. It's not bad. Thanks, Bill. People are going to come up here tonight and tell you all kinds of things. Remember, who's been working with the community groups over the last few years? That's what this campaign's all about. Who knows what the issues are? Who's been involved in this district of ours? My proposal for the revitalization of Rosendale Square is to have the city come into contract with the National Historical Trust, which has a Main Street project throughout the country, which deals directly with neighborhood shopping centers such as Rosendale Square. I have a master plan for Rosendale Square. Thank you.
My name is Linda, and I'm calling from Tom Menino's headquarters in Hyde Park. I was wondering, he's running for the district city council. If the election were held tomorrow, do you think you would consider him for your vote?
I'm doing a short survey for Tom Menino's office, who's running for district council in the Rosendale Hyde Park area. And you know,
it takes a lot of people to put pieces together. But the pieces are is election day and how that comes together and we're able to deliver our vote. We start phone calling around September 15th, and we've called the district once. We're on our second go-around to the district trying to identify the vote to get them out on election day. Now, what do you think, Jack?
Well, I'm just wondering how tired people are, right? We're going to be asking them to do a lot these next couple of days. If people have the energy, I think we should do it.
We'll have people standing out in the polls. We'll have people at elderly developments driving people to the voting places. We'll do everything we can to get as many people as we can who we know are Menino votes out, out that day.
Hi, I'm Tom Menino. Oh, yeah, appreciate the vote.
Remember my husband, Tom Menino, please. He's running for District City Council. Remember my husband, Tom Menino, please. He's running for District City Council. My husband, Tom Menino, please. He's running for District City Council. Remember my husband, Tom Menino, please. He's running for District City Council. Remember Tom Menino, please. He's running for District City Council.
Alright,
we're gonna click now live to David
Wilsey
in
1834
down in the
Mike Flynn. Yeah. Hi, we got 540 people and we're pretty well set.
Yeah,
it is high.
Significant news from the election department. At the 4 o'clock voter turnout across the city was 35%. That's a heavy number because the rule of thumb
493 to 85 in Georgetown. Oh man, I'd like to beat him his pants off.
We are here at Chelsea's in the financial district, and we will stay here. And as soon as Larry DeCara comes to us, we will bring him to you. Now let's go to the headquarters for
a place. And it's also beginning from the limited results.
Who's that?
Okay, go ahead. 1817. Yep. Yeah. Right.
1817?
Right. 1817. All right, give me another one. Okay, give me another one. 28? 28, yep. Right.
Can we Broadress?
And what is it, 127? Yep. What about Kenny? We didn't have Kenny there?
Come on, okay, we need Kenny, ahead. Guys.
Here's some numbers. We want numbers.
Yeah, he needs numbers. Thank you. Thank you.
Wow.
Okay. All right, I'll see you later. I'll call you when I leave.
16 is his.
694
yeah, 16 is his. 16 is the big one, which would be Kenny's home precinct. They're going to call us right back. Yeah. Hello. Yeah, who's this? Okay, Andy, what do you have?
Come on, guys.
Yeah. The 1816, go ahead.
It's home precinct.
498?
He beats us.
Go ahead. 393?
No, he doesn't! He doesn't!
And Broderick, 51?
He okay. Doesn't.
187? Okay, 18. What else you have? 20, precinct 1, go ahead. 4, yep. Yep.
Oh.
Yep, so far everything's good. We're just waiting for 3 more precincts.
Oh.
All right, take it easy.
Where's that? How we start this campaign again? I think how we start it maybe is by tomorrow morning. We go to the street corners.